keeping your buttock tucked under. Don't let it stick out like that, keep it tucked under. You bend your knees down, placing most of the weight straight down onto your right leg as your left hand comes straight down across and over onto your underneath your right palm as you breathe out. Now notice how the right toe has turned 45 degrees to the right on its heel. Don't move it like that. You must move it, swivel it on its heel like so. So that happens on your out-breath. You come straight down onto your right heel. Now notice my head is pointing towards the northeast, but my eyes are still looking this way to the north. Never in Taiji do you turn your head like this. Your head always turns to where your center is pointing, and your eyes do the looking for you. So I'll just repeat those couple of beginning movements again. This is called preparation. Breathe in, out. Breathe in, swing over to the left, keeping your palms that distance apart, and breathe out as you sink down and placing the weight onto your right leg as you turn your right toes out by 45 degrees. This is actually a block. The eyes are to the front. It's actually a block like that. But in Taiji, we only see a little bit of what's supposed to be done. This was to hide the original idea of Tai Chi, the martial applications, so that, I'm told, so that the Manchurians couldn't steal the Chinese martial arts. So they were hidden in a sort of an abstract form, if you like, and that's why Tai Chi, most people look at Tai Chi and say, gee, how can you use that for self-defense? Well, the movements are actually hidden within the form, but that's covered in another video. So I'll do that whole beginning movement again. Breathe in. Breathe out. Swing your palms out to the northeast. Breathe in, over to the left. Now sink down, both knees are bent, onto your right leg, turning your head, keeping your eyes to the front. Notice how there's still a fist distance under my arms. They're never ever in like this. From here you pick up your left heel and take a straight step straight down towards the north. Don't bring your foot across like this because that gives you a skinny stance. You must step so that the heel, the foot, goes in that same line and you only put your foot down to where it goes to naturally. You mustn't ever go like this so that there's weight on that front foot. I can't go anywhere from here. I've got to first change my weight and then pull my foot back. You must step. In Tai Chi, there's never any double weighted except for this beginning movement. My feet are even. From here on in, the weight is on either one leg. From here, keeping the chin in back straight, you step forward just to where your foot will go to, place it, you always stretch your foot leg out to its extent, and then just place the heel where it is, or where it wants to go to. Now as you roll forward onto your left heel, your left hand comes up in front of you, and your right palm goes back down to your right side as you breathe out. The left wrist here is in your center, this is called Pang, and your right palm is down by your right hand side. And the weighting is 70% on the front leg and 30% on the back leg. The back knee is just slightly bent, but the weighting is on your front leg and the back is straight, not like this. The back must be vertical. So that when you're looking at someone practicing Tai Chi, it mustn't look like this. If I move forward, now that's too much strain on my lower back because there's too much weight on the front leg. It must look as if the person is 70% weighted forward and 30% weighted back in this particular posture. So if I'm standing like this, that means it's 50-50. This is 70%. All right, those few movements again. Breathe out. Swing your hands up to the northeast corner, over to the northwest corner. Breathe out as you go straight down onto your right leg. Breathe in as you step forward. And breathe out as you do Pang. Now from here you do much the same movement. You bring your right palm through in a blocking motion. That would be the application. You bring your right palm through and flex the left hand just slightly. That's a little bit different than the Yang Ching Fu form. Pick up your right heel as you breathe in, turning your body and especially your eyes look to the east. Pick your right foot straight up off the ground and place the heel where it is. Don't bring it across again like this because that'll give you a skinny stance. Roll forward, taking your right palm straight up in front of your left palm and your back toes are dragged around by 45 degrees as you breathe out.
Now you take from this position your hands are looking like this, like they're holding a little ball. You turn both palms over. Your left palm turns palm up and your right palm turns palm down. But they mustn't move position like that. They must simply turn where they are so that the left hand can easily be slid inside of the right hand. They're both on this flat plane here, like this. So from here you've come to this posture, you breathe in as you turn your palms over. Now, it's like you're holding a big rope here, and you pull down to your left hand side as you breathe in. And your hands come down over your left thigh. Then you attach your left hand across your right wrist, straight across here, with the fingers only pointing upwards. So from here you turn your body with it, attach your hand across your wrist and breathe out as you lift straight back up to where you came from. I'll do the palm movements just for you now and then I'll go back and show you the whole body movement. From here you turn your right palm upwards so that it looks as like you're looking in a mirror. And you, as you sit back on your back leg, you drag your left palm around to the side of your head to the northeast corner. And then the right one comes around to meet it. You attach your hands again where they were before and do the similar movement only on a downward stroke as you breathe out this time. From here, the left hand rubs the right hand like so. You sit back on your back leg, bring both hands in like this and push forward with your forearms as you breathe out and push. Right, now I'll go back and show you how the whole body works from those positions. I'll go from the pung movement, block as you breathe in, pick up your right heel, place your heel where it is, roll forward to the east, dragging your back foot around by 45 degrees as your hips drag them around. That's double pung, that's called. You turn both hands over, turning slightly to the right, breathe in as you pull down to your left, attach your hands and breathe out. Turn your palm upwards, slide your left palm on your right wrist, sit back, bring your palm around to it, and breathe out on a downstroke. Brush your hands, sit back, bring your both palms right in, feel your backbone creasing here, breathing in, and push forward with your forearms, and right at the last second, very, very soft movement, you just let your palms turn over. There will be a slight shaking here when you get this movement correctly. I must explain to you what sung is. Sung is a most important Chinese word, which doesn't really mean to relax. If you relax totally, you fall on the ground, of course. Sung is an attitude. And when you see anyone doing Tai Chi, who knows what they're doing, you'll see this shake in their palm. Now that's quite uncontrollable shake. This is because the qi is said to extend to your fingers and to your palms, and it makes that slight shake happen. There's a qigong that we have to gain sung. I'll not go into it in too much detail here. You pull your palm back as you breathe in, bring it across your chest, and like you're throwing a ball. Now you just wait there until that starts to shake, with your eye looking at what's called the dragon mouth point, just between your thumb and forefinger. Notice how the palm, when you look at it, just starts to shake gently. So basically that's what sung is. And if the hand shakes, don't worry about it. When you see a really old person doing it, most people say, oh, the poor doddering old chap. But in actual fact, he's doing Tai Chi correctly. There is a slight shake at your palm. If you're totally relaxed, but not dead relaxed, totally relaxed with still a little bit of life in your palm so as to get the martial application coming out, you'll get this slight shake at the end of your palm. Hence the slight shake when you practice press. Now from this point, you sit back on your back leg and breathe in and pull your left hand in to your right elbow. The back of your hand is touching the elbow like this. Both palms are very relaxed, just like this.